So, good afternoon, everybody. So, today we are here to understand how to prepare our final project report. So, earlier we had a session on preparing our synopsis. So, most of you have submitted your synopsis as well. For them who some suggestions were there, I have communicated suggestions to them as well. And some of them have rectified that, and they have, most of you have started your project report, mostly completed the work, and now you must be in phase of writing the report, right? So you must have gathered the required data, and now you are moving towards actual collating that data, analyzing that data and representing it on paper. So this is very important step. It is as important as data collection. Okay, unless you represent it in a right way, the data has no importance. Okay, so there are certain pattern of writing your project report. So since our today I suppose that only quality management and nursing administration students are attending this session. So today's project report, how to write project report will be explained, keeping in view the project report for postgraduate diploma of quality management and nursing administration only. And this project report, we have prepared this format keeping in view the level of our program is diploma level. So we do not expect too much statistical analysis in this. So basic percentages and mean, this much of mathematical intervention is sufficient for this project report level. Okay, so from the beginning, if we start, this project report course starts with your synopsis. Okay, so you have submitted your synopsis. For them whose title was approved with modifications, it was mentioned in that approval mail that whatever suggestions given to you, you have to incorporate them in your report. Okay, and then you will be preparing your final report and then submitting. So please do not use the same content that you have submitted in your synopsis on which suggestions are given to you. Suppose on literature review, if the evaluator has given the comment in your approval report that more studies needs to be included, then please include more studies. Don't just as it is submit or include in your project report. Okay, so whatever suggestions given on your synopsis, if they have asked you to change your title, then change your title, include in your project report and then submit it. So whatever suggestions given in your synopsis, include them, okay, incorporate them with in your project report and then submit. If you have any queries in the sense if you do not accept the suggestions given by the evaluator, please contact us. We will discuss it and then you proceed for your final report, okay. It should not happen that the same suggestion was given in your synopsis, but it was not incorporated and same thing is replicated in the report. So so unnecessary, you know, in evaluation and marking, it will be challenging. It becomes challenging for you as well as us. So better way, if you have any queries related to suggestions given on your synopsis, please discuss it with us and then rectify it and then submit your final project report. Okay, so moving on. So what did, just a second, I don't know why this is not, okay. So your synopsis, as you all know, this project report is a 50 marks course, 4 credit. So out of this 50 marks, 15 marks are given for your synopsis, 35 marks are given for your final project report. Okay, so submission date for synopsis was 1st Jan, and submission of final project report is 15th of March. Okay, so 15th of March, how it should reach us? It should reach us by post in hard copy. Okay, so some of students have mailed me that if I post it on 14th March and it reaches you beyond 15th March, is it acceptable? Yes, it is acceptable. You have to post it before 15th March. Ideally, it should reach us 15th March, but considering the pandemic situation, courier problems, your work problems, you know, your duties, you all are healthcare professional, working healthcare professionals. So your leaves and all, considering that, 1 week delay will be acceptable. Okay. So this was about your deadline. Your synopsis was having these chapters, the same slide that you have seen during your synopsis. It had title of project, it had introduction, aim and objectives, review of literature, methodology and references it had. Okay. So most of the headings, these all headings are same in your project report also. Okay, so what are the additional sections that you need to add in your project report? Let us see. Title of your project, it is as same as synopsis, but please include these things. Title, like the title can be assessment of patient satisfaction towards nursing services with a view to improve nursing care quality. Okay, if it is a title, then completely title you have to write. Okay, so before that, accessorial logo will come. Okay, then title of your program, then name of the title of your project, then name of the program, postgraduate diploma in nursing administration or postgraduate diploma in quality management of hospital and healthcare organization, then your name, then your PRN, and then your guide name. Okay, guide name and his designation will come. The later comes acknowledgements. Okay, acknowledgements you have to, whoever you want to acknowledge, your guide, your assistants, your whoever, like your family. So acknowledgements you all must be aware. Then is plagiarism declaration. It is very important. The format is given in the learner handbook. Please note, without plagiarism declaration, your project report will not be accepted. What it should say? It should say that whatever I have represented, included in this report is genuine to my knowledge, and I have not copied it from anywhere else. Okay, so this is the gist of the plagiarism declaration. Please include that. Please do include. Okay, without that, it will not get accepted. Sign that plagiarism declaration without fail. Okay, and include that page. Then comes synopsis approval mail. So approval mail that you have received from us, that is to be included. Then certificate from your project guide. Okay, now comes the main important part. So I think I have missed here the table of contents. After your certificate from your guide, table of contents should come. Okay. Introduction, aim and objectives, literature review, methodology, result, discussion, summary and conclusion, bibliography and appendices. Okay, so introduction, aim, objectives, literature review, methodology, these parts were common in your synopsis. and the acknowledgement, plagiarism declaration, synopsis approval, certificate, result discussion, summary conclusion, and bibliography are the additional sections that will be that will complete your project report. Okay, so we will see one by one how we are going to describe each and every additional section. Okay. So to begin with, your final project report should be description of your project work and findings. It should be concise. It should be organized into logical framework. On the same point, at the same time, it should be easy to understand and supported by well-established facts in consistent manner. Do not include your personal opinions. And most importantly, it should be certified from your project guide. So as you are aware, project guide is the supervisor who will guide you on what is reasonable to expect from a project in your chosen topic. Okay, so you must be aware that the qualification for your project guide is minimum master's degree with minimum 2 years of experience, or anybody who is MPhil or PhD in the relevant field. Okay. So your report should answer following questions. What you did, why did it, how you did it, what you got, what does that mean? So how will you answer what you did? With the help of introduction. Okay. Why did it? This data will be divided over, this description will be divided over these section: introduction, objectives, and literature review. Then how you did it is your methodology. What you got is will be presented in your result and discussion section. Then what does that mean is your conclusion, summary and conclusion. Okay, so all in all, introduction gives the reader of the piece of thread so they can follow it. In the introduction, you need to explain the reasons why you took a specific topic of your project. Okay, so introduction includes, as you have seen this in our synopsis, it includes background information about your topic, brief introduction of the organization, so identification of need for further investigation, then explaining the main concept of the topic, and key terms applicable and unresolved issues related to the topic. Okay, these things we need to include in our introduction. In case it is not included at the time of your synopsis, please revise it and include all these things in your introduction. Then comes your objectives. So objectives should be specific and measurable. Suppose your the earlier title, that patient satisfaction towards quality of nursing care. So you should not directly write your objectives like assessment of nursing care, assessment of patient satisfaction. So your objective should be how you are going to achieve that assessment. How are you going to achieve that assessment? So to identify the problems. So you have to break down that aim into smaller objectives. Okay. Then comes literature review. So literature review, as you know, is a comprehensive summary of previous research on the topic. The literature review surveys scholarly articles, books, and other sources relevant to a particular area of research. The review should enumerate, describe, summarize, objectively evaluate, and clarify these previous researches. Okay, So you will search for literature related to your research problem or your topic. Then is result and discussion section. Methodology. How did you proceed about your project work? So what steps did you take to collect your data? Whom did you target? Okay, whatever your objectives were, to achieve those objectives, what exactly you did is your methodology. Like you circulated, you prepared a questionnaire, circulated among which group, okay, for how much duration it was there, how it was analyzed, what was the field, it was a hospital, within a hospital it was an OPD or it was an IPD or OT. So these things will come in your methodology. Then is result and discussion and conclusion. We will discuss these two sections separately with the due course of this presentation. Yeah, results. So result is representation of the obtained data in tables, graphs and charts in logical sequence. It is a contextual analysis of the data, explaining its meaning in sentence form. The collected data should be in line with your objectives. Okay, so information in figures, charts should be relatively self-explanatory, and their design should include all definition and other information necessary for readers to understand the findings without reading all the text. Okay, so if you are analyzing certain patient satisfaction, then whatever your tool was, suppose your tool was questionnaire, you have prepared a questionnaire for patients about nursing satisfaction. So your question is, how clear and complete were the nurses' explanation about test, treatment and what is expected? So this is a question. So whatever your scale is, excellent, good, very good, poor or average. So you will prepare a table. Okay, you will write your questions and number of answers that you have got. How many have rated excellent? How many have rated poor? So that number will come in front of that question. Okay, this kind of table you have to prepare. So whatever you have got, you can put it in Excel and you can get a graph of it as well. Okay, so table and the graph. In this way, you will present your results. Then discussion. So discussion is a important part, major center of your project. So whatever you have received in your results, here you are going to elaborate those results. So what is the meaning of those findings? Suppose I have received that my question is, how friendly and kind were nurses to you? So I have got almost out of say for 60 sample size, I have received 25 out of 60 saying that the kindness of nurses was average or poor. Then what is the significance of this finding that we need to discuss here? What are the probable reasons that I will write in the discussion section? Not only this, I have prepared a I have done a literature review. So based on that literature review, how my whatever literature reviews articles have given conclusion, are they matching with my study? If they are matching, then how they correlate with each other? And if they are not matching, then what are the reasons of this variance? Okay, so why nursing impacts? Okay, so nursing care is very important service in a hospital. So how nursing care, good nursing care is important for quality of your service and how it can create a positive impression about my organization amongst the patients, its family, and at the end, the society. So in this way, I have to write my discussion section. So we are not supposed to include any new ideas here, but we will reason whatever findings that I have obtained and how these findings are related with the literature review. Okay, so purpose of this discussion is to interpret and describe the significance of your findings in light of what is already known about the problem statement being investigated. And we have to explain any new understanding or fresh insights about the problem after you have taken the findings into considerations. So discussion should indicate how you manage to arrive at a solution to the problem or task and how your methodology could be improved. Based on this discussion section, recommendations can be made concerning the implementation and general applicability and suitability of findings, as well as suggestions of the topic for further research. Before that, for them who are doing a descriptive study, like they are not going to collect any data, they are just going to collect literature review based on literature review only, or currently followed practices they are going to refer, for them result and discussion section will get combined. They will not be able to prepare any graphs or charts. What they will do, result and discussion section will be combined. In that section, they will suppose there is a title, effectiveness of NABH accreditation on care delivery, or need of NABH accreditation in the digital era. This is the title, then whatever findings, whatever literature review I have searched, whatever conclusion or abstracts that I have studied, based on that I have to conclude. I have to shortlist my findings. These many articles have given that NABH accreditation can improve your processes and thereby ultimately causing rise in your patient satisfaction, or ultimately reducing your errors happening in the process, or staff satisfaction can be increased through this improved processes. So these many articles have quoted, and even few more studies can be done. You can identify more research areas into that. So these things will be included in your result and discussion section if you are doing descriptive study. Okay, so let us move to the next session, that is summary and conclusion. Okay, summary, you can just call it as a summary or conclusion. It should be summary or conclusion. So conclusion is whatever you have covered till now. So you will write it in a gist, as well as it will also include the key points where you recommend new ideas for future. So your recommendations are also to be included in this summary and conclusion chapter. Suppose you have obtained that the communication skills of the nurses need to be improved, or nurses are not giving priority to the privacy of patients, then a training session should be conducted so as to emphasize or reiterate the issue of privacy of patients or family, or explaining, giving information while taking consent. So these issues you can highlight and make recommendations regarding that. So for summary and conclusion, you can complete this in 3 to 4 paragraphs. Okay, so 3 to 4 paragraphs are sufficient for this. As you can read on the slide, that this is section is intended to help the reader understand why your study should matter to them after they have finished reading the paper. Okay, so here we will restate the topic, why topic is important in concise manner. We will summarize the main points, whatever we have obtained through literature review and our data collection or analysis. Then we will state in short the significance of result that I have obtained, and then conclude my thoughts. So conclude your thoughts means what is the final achievement of your project and what are the future researches or future gaps that needs to be addressed for the betterment. Okay, so we have to state conclusion in clear and simple language. Do not reiterate your results or discussion. Completely, we are not going to write our discussion section here. Indicate opportunities for future research if you haven't already done so in the discussion section of your paper. Okay. Indicate opportunities. Yeah. So next section is bibliography. I think you have most of you have written bibliography correctly. As we have seen it in the synopsis, bibliography is a complete list of references used in a piece of writing, including the author name, date of publication, title, okay, publication year or so. So this is the format, APA format that we follow, American Psychology Association. So please write this. Okay, so whatever articles you are taking into considerations, they needs to be referred. So appendices, questionnaire and checklist. So whatever questionnaire you have prepared, you have circulated, that will be the format of that to be included in the questionnaire. So this is the again important part, instructions for typing and printing. Please go through it. This the same information is also available in your learner handbook. Okay, so finalization of your project report. Once it is done, so you have to prepare a project report in this way. Let me show you. I hope it is visible. So here you can see the name is written, Symbiosis Center of Healthcare. Here what will come? Symbiosis School for Open and Distance Learning. Okay. So a project report on quality management of dental clinic, patient satisfaction perspective and communication. So here title, submitted by Sunil Pandey under guidance of Sachin Bhalla, Director Dental Care. Designation is written here. Then submitted to HCHC. So it was the older name of our institute. So in this way we have to hard bind, we have to do. Okay, I hope it is visible. Okay, and then so in this way, I think you must have be aware, most of you must be aware that in this way the project binding happens. This way, introduction page. Each page is to be written on new section and written in this way, including. Okay. See, student declaration he has given, he has signed it. I will also show you the guide certificate. This is the guide certificate he has obtained. Okay. He has signed and given his stamp also. Okay, so this is a guide certificate. Okay, so this you have to similar way do. Okay, so this was the format. It is already given in the learner handbook that word limit is 8000 to 10,000 words, excluding your figures and graphs. You have included 5 pages of your images, and then 30 pages project you have submitted, then it will not be accepted. So your written content should be 30 to 45 pages, okay? And on the top of that, you can include the whatever certificates or images or, you know, illustrations and all. So also, if this 30 to 45 page will exclude the acknowledgement, declaration, approval mail, guide mail, okay? So excluding that from your introduction to your result discussion should be of 30 to 45 pages. So binding, I have shown you that this kind of golden embossing we have to do. Okay, hard cover binding. So now please note that project report will not be considered for evaluation if it is submitted without approved project synopsis. Okay, you are not submitting synopsis and directly submitting project report, it will not get accepted. Or it is less than 30 pages. Or it is too lengthy, more than 50 pages or text, so it will also not get accepted. Then simply a study of observation or review of activities or literature without any valid conclusion or recommendation. So your opinion is very important. So you are just doing literature review and submitting it, that will also not get accepted. Handwritten project, yes, you need a typewritten project like this. Okay, you have to type it, print it, bind it, and then send it. Okay, not related to initial project proposal that was sent for approval. So, if your approval is given on, say, for registration process, study of registration process, and you are submitting patient satisfaction, then it will not be accepted. Okay, and you are not supposed to say that, no, I didn't get the data, this is COVID situation, I will not be able to do so. Please avoid these situations, okay? So whatever you have submitted in your synopsis, please include it. Plagiarism, very important part. You all must be aware that nowadays, everybody is very sensitive about plagiarism. So try not to copy any line in your project report. Whatever you are taking, you have to paraphrase it, you know, active to passive voice, you have to use synonyms. Suppose here is a line, if any plagiarized content is found in your report, it will be rejected. So you cannot take the line as it is, you have to paraphrase it. Like, your project report will get plagiarized, project report will get rejected. In this way, you have to convert it. Okay. So please convert whatever data you are taking as far as possible. Only just the definitions, if you are taking a health, support definition of health, that is universal. Then don't convert it in your language and include it. So whatever in a literature review paragraph is there, so that you have to convert in your own language and then include. And even if you convert in your own language, you have to acknowledge it in your bibliography or reference section, okay? It's not that you have converted in your own words, so I will not acknowledge. No, but the idea you have taken from them, that is why you have to include in the reference section. Okay, so what is plagiarism? It is copying as it is without their knowledge, quoting directly, paraphrasing and not acknowledging. We have to paraphrase and acknowledge, okay? Paraphrasing and not acknowledging. So copying of ideas as it is, copying and pasting verbatim and not giving source credit. Okay, like some definition is there, CDC's definition is there, you have copied it, but in your reference, you are not saying that this is definition taken from which source. So you have to explain it. So what are the do's and don'ts? So here you can see, as you can see, that you have to write it in your own words, formal writing style and simple words, correct grammar and correct citation. Okay. And don'ts is plagiarism, of course, blurry figures in tables, double spacing and conversational style. Okay, so these are the don'ts and these are the do's. So please follow the do's and avoid the don'ts while you are preparing your project report. So if you have any further queries, you can just type in the chat box. Thank you for patient listening so far, because you know this is a very patient listening. I'm saying because here is no option to make any noise, na? So that is why the patient listening. So this is a by default patient listening. So whatever queries you have, you please post it in the chat box. Okay. Radhika is asking, what will be summary in analysis of training conducted in hospital? So if you ask, so is it your project title that training conducted, it must be effectiveness of training conducted in hospital, na? So if you are studying the effectiveness of training, you have to take responses of the participants. So you must have prepared a questionnaire for them then. Or you can, you must have obtained data like what is the change in their attitude or in their skill after this training program. By observation method, if you are going to pre and post, before the training program, what were their knowledge, and after the training program, what were their skills and knowledge. So you have to analyze it. So if you analyze that, you have to, you know, how it has affected the training program, how they it has affected their knowledge or skill, that you will include in the discussion section. And summary is of course how the training program, whatever you have done it, will come into your summary part. Okay, so okay, it is not with the no, it is it's not very much to CA, like, you know. If you can see right now, how we should add the approval mail. Okay, you have to print it. That print you have to bind at the time of binding. The approval mail at the time of binding, you have to give to that printer to include that, you know, at number 4 or number 5. Okay. Neeti Joshi is asking, ma'am, do we have to share the project report on portfolio? No, no need to share on portfolio, only the hard copy you have to share. In the case the hard copy, we receive the hard copy in a, you know, not a readable way. In courier it got misplaced or it got distorted, then we will ask you for, but it doesn't happen. So far it has not happened. So we get the hard copy. And in case so happens, then you will submit, we will ask you for the soft copy. But please be ready with your soft copy. Don't say that I have deleted it, now it is not with me. Okay. So please keep the soft copy as well as hard copy with you. Submit the hard copy to us. And if required, we may ask you for the soft copy. Are we supposed to follow the same table of content provided by SSOD? You can edit it. It's not very hard and fast. As per the scope of your project or nature of your project, you can change some of the headings. Just want to know if the original data collected can be attached at the end of the project. No, we do. You don't need to attach the entire data. Okay, Kamalakshi, there is no need to add the entire data. The data you are going to represent in your result section, whatever you have obtained, is to be represented in a tabular or graphical manner. Okay, so you have to just include the tool, data collection tool, in your annexure. Spiral binding of project report. I stay out of India. Having heart bound with golden embossing seems a bit difficult. Please advise. Heart bound is, you know, this is what the protocol and routine practice is. I'm not sure if the spiral binding is acceptable or not. You please write me a mail. I will seek guidance from academic committee. But as far as my knowledge is concerned, the hard bound with golden embossing, if not golden embossing, but at least hard bound, you should do. Okay, one more question. Guide letter should be on letterhead or any blank page? Guide letter can be on blank page because it comes with the stamp and seal, na? That is sufficient. It can be on blank page. If your guide is ready to give you on letterhead, then it is fine. Soft copy of report. Okay, I will try because I have not, frankly speaking, I have not prepared any report as such to show you. This I am showing because it is in hard copy. I have it in hard copy because students, the synopsis, I have prepared it in my own. I have prepared it. I have collected. I have done that study in past. So that's why I have shared it. I was involved in that. But this time, this is the student's report. So that is why I am not able to share it in soft copy. I have just the hard copies. But still, I will show you. Please wait. I have one online article I have, the nursing satisfaction letter I was saying. I will just show you. Please wait. Data is in the form of, Kamalakshi saying the data is in the form of checklist, WHO observation form. How do I represent the checklist in the report? As long as it is 4 pages, 5 pages, whatever the questions are, whatever the parameters are there, no, that will come in a column. In this way, you have 5 pages checklist. Five pages you have to include. Font of the pending project binding. It's not really visible. Is it okay? Is it visible now?
Screen mode ko dala tum sir aur PPT mode se karna
hai. It is it nahi.
PPT ka to pass kar
sir. Okay, I will now stop sharing. I think the screen, it will be visible now. Okay, in this way, I hope it is visible now. So in this way it is done. So it is older one, huh? Symbiosis Center of Healthcare. It is not a new one. In this way we have to write it. So this is acknowledgements. So please wait, I will just open the This is one of the article that I have come across, and I felt it is good for referencing. I have got a question anonymously that my connection was interrupted. Not sure if my question was replied. If you could repeat again, if can I spiral bind my report? Yeah, you have to give a hard bound. This is what the routine protocol and practice is. So I'm not sure if the spiral bind is acceptable also. Most of the students submit the hard bind only. Is it visible? Just a second. I will just check if it is visible. Yeah. Yeah. I think it is visible, na? See here, assessment of patient satisfaction with nursing care. Okay, so it is a published research actually. So introduction, I will just show how is the representation of graph is done. See, bar graph showing patient level with quality of nursing care. So whatever obtained here, they have represented. Then socio demographic characteristics they have represented. So this part is not relevant with us, so don't include it. We will go to this chart. Okay, this was the questionnaire. I hope it is visible, na? Just a second, let me check. Yes, it is. It is visible. I can see on the next computer next to me. So this is the questionnaire. Okay, these are the responses. Excellent. So 5% said excellent, 43% said 52, 0.9% said poor. Okay, so in this way we have obtained. And this is the, after every result, the discussion part is given. So this is the graph. Okay, discussion of results and conclusion. And for binding, if you want now. So for binding, I cannot do anything now. It's very simple. If you go to any printer now, they will give you this. Radhika, content of guides certificate is already given in your project format. If you go to the project format on your LMS, na, you will get the guide certificate. Patient Kali, Mr. Kali Prasad is asking, patient IP number and name related to project report need to reflect in. No, patient, we don't need patient exact details, na? That is why we are representing the data, because we are not going to privacy and individual responses, we are not interested. So whatever your findings are, you have to represent. Also, share checklist for descriptive study. No, descriptive study doesn't have any checklist, na? So whatever your topic is, na, whatever your findings after reviewing the literature, whatever you have obtained, that you on your own you have to represent, you have to jot down the points. Yeah, Radhika. Okay, Radhika, please give me your email ID. I will share the project format with you. The question is asked, please, can you share the format for descriptive study? Okay, format for descriptive study is same. Okay, in your methodology, you will write as descriptive study, the literature, the articles having these keywords were searched. These articles were excluded, these articles were included, what was the duration. So you can say that before 2000 or 2005, before 2005 the studies were excluded. All these come in your methodology, and in your result and discussion section is will be combined then. Otherwise rest of the sections will be same for your descriptive study. So any further queries? I have to share project format with Radhika. Radhika, I will share it on your mail, but you know, if you go to the LMS, na, read study material, there you will find project indicative title list or such headings you will get. There you will get the project report format also. But no problem, we will share the format with you. If there are any queries, you can please post in the chat box. Yes, even for descriptive study, the person who has named himself as himself herself anonymous, please give your name. Yeah, so anonymously it has been asked that do I need guide certificate for descriptive study? Yes, even for descriptive study, project guide certificate is must. Radhika, thank you for your email ID. I will send you the project report format. Madam, your direct number can you share? Direct number is, yeah, I have my direct number. Just a second, I will give you. I will post it. So this is my direct extension. Okay. हो का ओके करा सेवड़ा और बोलो कर सेवड़ा बोलो ओके सो व्हाट आई हैव सेड दैट डू आई नीड डिस्क्रिप्टिव चार्ट्स इन डिस्क्रिप्टिव स्टडी मोस्टली नो डिस्क्रिप्टिव स्टडी विल नॉट हैव चार्ट्स सो मंजुला हैव आस्क्ड मी टू शेयर माय ईमेल दैट आई विल डू या प्रोजेक्ट रिपोर्ट बाय 25th मार्च मंजुला प्लीज राइट मी एन ईमेल this is not the right place to discuss about the delays. Yeah, Tintu has asked me to share the project format, but I will share the project format with everyone. Okay, this I will do. So I will ask Mr. Dilip to share the project format with all the students. So it will be helpful for everyone then. So my email ID is @sqsodl.edu.in. Okay. Are there any more queries? Because we have next session, query resolution session. If you have any other queries, now this is the query resolution session for this month. Huh? So you please ask other queries here as well. So I think there are no more queries now. So in case you have any further, queries or whatever, complaints, whatever you have, you please send me email. I have also given my direct extension number. You can call on that number. Okay, so I think this is the goodbye for today. We will meet for further sessions on exams, your examination forms and all, okay? So first of all, you please be prepared right now for the project report submission. Please do well, please do submit a nice report, okay? Because we are studying in a distance learning mode, your project report mean a lot. So you have done the project report, actual hands-on experience you have obtained about your entire theory through project report. So that is why please prepare project report sincerely. Okay, so have a nice day ahead. Stay safe, take good care of yourself. Okay, bye.